different about the natural state. In terms of my experiences, I mean, I see a lot of, you know, very close similarity. The thing I find is that I'm seeing is different is there's, I'm getting more of an energetic reaction that
okay.
rather than just being this sort of calmness and non-thinking, I feel that there's more kind of a, almost like a sort of glowing very often in my body and you know, feelings in my arms and so physically there is something that's different there.
Right.
I wonder if you could, you know, maybe enlarge a bit. And why is this different? And I mean, clearly there's not just one notion of what samadhi or awareness is.
Yeah. Well, as I'm sitting here in the front, I'm always, you know, checking how everybody's practicing, if there is something to correct, or whether it is correct, and I have seen it with, you know, not only with you guys and girls, but also with many other practitioners who have had like some history, some background in sutra-style practices, that, like you said, something changes, like they energetically change, their face changes, their energetic appearance, their feel changes when they take up tantric practices. Well, sure, in silent illumination, as it's called in Chinese Zen, that silent illumination, which you know, silent illumination comes from the natural state. It silently illuminates itself, and the natural state of Chogyam teachings, Mahamudra teachings, Zen teachings. It's all the same natural state. So as Kairo was pointing out in the session we had first thing this morning, was that you said something referring to this. Well, you were giving several pointers, but you know, there's only one natural state and only one Buddha nature, so there's no change there. It is either recognized or left unrecognized, right? And that's actually a very important point, because well, from my own experience, I can say that I had years of practice, I did years of practice, and there was very, very little, like a minimal amount of like proper glimpses, proper recognition of the natural state. Actually, those glimpses happened very rarely during practice. So they happened when I stopped practicing, like when I sat from the cushion, and then it would happen. But I didn't know what it was. I didn't know until I, you know, had studied Dzogchen, studied, you know, the non-dualistic view later. So this is actually very, very, you know, important point that, as I often say, that mental calmness, quietude, may or may not be the natural state. Our mind can be thoughtless, but it might not be the natural state. So there is this thing called substrate consciousness, alaya vijnana, that is talked and underlined by many Dzogchen masters of the past centuries in their texts, which separates this, well, for the sake of clarity, I will define it as thoughtless state from the natural state. Because even if you don't have thoughts, sort of like if you look at those lamps, I remember 6 months ago when I was sitting here, I was also referring to these same lamps. So if we think of these lamps, or that thing in the center in the ceiling, or those paintings, or that tanka, or any other objects in this space, we could remove all of them, and that would be like thoughtless state. No thoughts, no objects in the space. But then, what the substrate consciousness refers to are these subtle veils, like very subtle fog, vapor in that space. In this space now we don't have vapor, but we can imagine that if we had a, like in nightclubs there are smoke machines. What do you call them?
Smoke machines.
Dry ice. 10 people saying it the same time.
What you
said. Yeah, right.
Smoke machines. Okay. So if we had a smoke machine here, and you know, it gave out smoke, and there had been a moment when it got a lot thinner, and eventually more and more thin, more and more thin. It is still there if you look at carefully, and it gets thinner and thinner and thinner. But if it fills the whole space, the whole room, and it's very, very thin, you might not be able to see it, notice it, unless somebody pointed out to you. And this somebody is the Mahasiddha Guru, Guru Yoga. So there are practice styles. I try not to criticize other kinds of paths anymore, because I've done it a lot, and it does a disservice to open heart system, because other people who are following those paths think that I'm pointing out to their mistakes and, you know, making myself feel good, which is not something I've ever done. That was not my motivation. But there are approaches that don't make this distinction between the subtle veils and the natural state. So the mistake that happens there is that they can sit in these subtle veils and think, make the mistake of believing that that's the natural state. So yeah, that's a big mistake actually, in many schools of teaching, both in Buddhism and otherwise. So you were asking about the previous practice. Well, I'm not sure if the definition is that silent illumination meditation would, you know, essentially it would have to be the same as non-meditation, sitting in the Buddha nature. But if you have loads of these subtle veils that you're sitting in, obviously by definition it's not silent illumination in that case. So these sensations, opening, bhumi openings, purification of mind through mantras, tantric practices that we have, fixes the problem, removes those stuff that might have been, you know, maybe not forcefully suppressed, but kind of just somehow under the lid, not in a forceful way. Because this is what happens, like if we take the thoughtless state, still like the quietude, mental quietude as the path, if we think that that's the natural state, well, what happens when we do mindfulness practices, concentration practices? What happens is that when we have some attention, have some concentration, mind becomes quiet. all the chatter and thoughts you had before, they go away into the periphery, right? You have a moment of stillness, which is a very useful experience, but that cannot be taken as the path, because that's just calmness, that's just mental quietude. So maybe that's, you know, that's probably what you're talking about.